Well, it was formed, of course, towards the end of August, inaugurated, put it that way, and by Colonel Hughes, who was then the leader of the Conservative Party in Sheffield, Colonel Branson. There were a terrific rush for membership. Finally, it was mobilised in the drill hall, Edmund Road, something like 1,200
people.
Assembled there, mobilised and then formed into companies, ultimately five companies. We had a reserve company, an E company, and we went to Norfolk Park for training. Every morning at 9 a.m., the drill hall, and every week we were paid a guinea. 14 shillings for 2 shillings a day, I think it was, for subsistence. 1 shilling a day pay. I think that was the figure. 21 to a guinea.
Did you have a uniform in those days, in the early days?
No, I'm coming to that. Yes, we didn't have a uniform at all. We ordinary attire. And then, towards the end of, in the middle of November, I think, 1914, we were supplied with a uniform, which was of a bluish-grey colour. And then get a cap.
With a red stripe down the side, I think.
Yes. And, because remember, this is the end of the summer. And it was a very, very warm period. With the result that as we marched down one thing, Edmund Road and the Norfolk Park, somebody heard this from some lady sitting in St. Mary's Road on the doorsteps. One lady said to the other, she said, "It must be a terrible war this, while they have to turn the convicts out to fight."
Yeah. It doesn't say much.
They look like convicts, no? We got this grey, wasn't a khaki.
Yeah.
It was a bluish grey uniform. Mm. Yes, so we were, and of course we had, it was such a beautiful autumn. You sit in the grass and talk and lectures on hygiene. And then we moved in December. We moved to Red Marsh. I think we were in this convict uniform until we got to Red Marsh. Then we were issued with a khaki, Broderick caps and so on, so. Because I can remember at Red Marsh when we were assembled to draw our uniforms, Quartermaster Sergeant Doncaster. I remember his famous remarks. We were served with our caps and on Brodericks. They call them Brodericks. Mm. I don't know why. He'd put one on a bloke and he'd just sat on the top of his head, you know. He said, "Fits you beautifully," he said. "It's a bit small, isn't it, Quarters?" The Quarters replied and said, "It'll stretch when the sun gets at it." Oh, the next bloke came over, he went, ducked onto his ears, you see. And all Quarters, he had to apply for everything at Quarters. He said, "Oh," he said, "it'll shrink when it rains." "It'll fit you."
Yeah.
The funny thing was, we marched from from the drill hall up to the various equipment, bags and cetera, Red Marsh. Got installed in these huts, there's no preparation for it at all. And the funny thing was that the majority of us went back into town at night and walked back, got the last tram from town to Nethergreen and walked up to Red Marsh at night.
Yeah.
Some of us, because there was a fair number of people with wealth, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And they used to take a taxi back. Long way, you know. Who was the first colonel?
Colonel Mainwaring.
Mainwaring came, Mainwaring. Typical old Indian sweat. He's the man I interviewed about a commission. At least he interviewed me. Which is probably a different thing.
Uh-huh.
For a commission. fatigued. He stayed with us until... He didn't go out with us, you know, he didn't go to France. I mean, he didn't go to Egypt. Mm-hmm. I don't know what happened to him.
And then in May, you were moved down to Cannock Chase, wasn't
it? Yes, that's right. Penrith.
Can you remember much about the camp at Cannock Chase, or...
Well, we were... We were the first troops there. We were always the advanced body. We'd have to squad back in Sheffield, you know. We'd have to squad at Redmars.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the reserve company.
Yes, that was left at Redmars. Mm-hmm. We were, I think ultimately, we were about 1,500 strong, you know, including E Company. Mm-hmm. The whole battalion, about 1,500 strong. Mm-hmm. All kinds of...
Were you issued with rifles down at Cannock Chase?
We had some rifles. Mm-hmm. We had some rifles that were some old-fashioned ones.
Yeah. Did you get the new Lee Enfield?
No, we didn't get the Lee Enfield.
You didn't get the Lee Enfield.
We didn't get to until we got to Lark Hill. Uh-huh. That's all we were playing.
Uh-huh. And then from Cannock Chase you went up to Ripon.
Yes, we did. First troops at Ripon.
For a short period.
Very pleasant. Yeah. Then we went to Cannock Chase to be finished off.
Uh-huh. and then you got word that you were going abroad, and you moved down to Salisbury Plain,
Lark Hill,
to be prepared for your journey out to wherever you were going.
Egypt.
Did you know where you were going at the time when you got to?
No, we were going to the Mediterranean.
You were going to the Mediterranean.
But we were on the tail of Gallipoli, you know. Mm-hmm. We were supposed to be going to Gallipoli. Mm-hmm. And of course they stopped the operation. We went to Valletta. Mm-hmm. Malta.
Yeah.
Lovely spot. First time we saw these kids diving in the water, catch spinnies.